Hello, 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 wonderful people.
Wow.
Hello, your afternoon, everyone. Thank you guys, ladies and gentlemen, for joining me live right now. Afternoon, everyone. Thank you guys, you all are the best. You all are the best, I tell you. You all are the best. You all are the best. Thank you, your sister Ellen. Thank you, girl, for joining me. God bless you. Belle, Belle, thank you for joining. I appreciate you, sir. Husband and wife still dealing with boyfriend and girlfriend, families. All about savings, all about retirement, all about working together. God bless you all for joining me. Stay tuned. Invite someone else. Simon, thank you for joining. Oluwale, thank you. Osati, thank you. JC Ogu, I appreciate you. God bless you guys for joining me. Just a few more minutes and we'll get started. Bolaji, I appreciate you for joining. Charles, thank you for joining me. God bless you. You are welcome this afternoon. I hope we're all doing well today. Beautiful Wednesday. We are almost rounding out the week, going towards weekends. You know how we do it. Love, love, love. I can't wait to see Friday, Saturday, Sunday by the grace of God. And we'll talk about love. But we're talking about our finances right now. May the Lord help us. I do not own the copyright of this song being played, but let's enjoy it. Thank you, guys. Stay tuned, invite someone else. Thank you, Admin One. Yes, we thank all our fans for joining us this afternoon. What a beautiful day. Prince Harry, I appreciate you, sir, for joining me. God bless you. Invite someone else. It's a beautiful day. I will give God all the praise for his grace and his mercy, for the opportunity once again to be in the land of the living. It's not because of our righteousness, but his grace and mercy, you know, has kept us here. And we owe him all the praise. Thank you, Lord. May the Lord take over this broadcast this afternoon in the name of Jesus. Like I always say, this is your very own Jesse of Sisters True Love Group International, all the way from Houston, Texas, shouting out to all of you. Thank you guys for joining me. Stay tuned, invite someone else as we unfold and continue to unfold things concerning retirement. And now we want to talk about what income in a family, the effect of it concerning your retirement. Stay tuned. Lydia, you're welcome. Wuka, you are welcome. God bless you. Afternoon. As we wait for others to join us, let's get started because the day is running so fast. It's almost 4 o'clock in the state here in Houston, Texas. We are still talking about retirement. We are still talking about saving money. We are still talking about breaking protocols. We are still talking about breaking generational curse of poverty. We are still on that topic. And guys, this topic will take us over and over again. We want people to see the seriousness of being able to plan for older age. Now we're talking about one income in a family, how it's going to affect you towards saving for your retirement age and planning for the family as a whole. Thank you, Princess from Dallas, for joining me. God bless you. Clear, you're welcome. Olutani, thank you. Wosu, thank you for joining. God bless you guys. I am so humbled to be in your presence this afternoon. We are still talking about retirement. We're talking about couples, one income. The sad news about one income in a family of two. What do I mean? Where husband is the only one working. And that will take us to say a single mom or a single dad who is working alone, dealing with one income and planning for the future. Retirement. We'll have an alert. I'll tell people dial 911. When it comes to retirement topics, we have to call it an emergency. Life-threatening emergency. That's what retirement is. That's what it is to have one income in a family. It is a life-threatening emergency. And I want us to invite more people. I want us to talk about it. I want us to share ideas. However you're doing it to scale through poverty, however you're doing it to help your family to save, if you can input that for us, others will read it, it will be of a good help. If you can share your ideas, how you're surviving financially and the plans that you're making for your future to break generational curse, we want to welcome that idea on this broadcast. It's an open broadcast. It's not a broadcast that is restricting people from communicating. We want you to be able to bring your ideas on the table so we all can dialogue and reason together. Cherry, thank you for joining me. God bless you. Miss Tessie, you are welcome. Justice, thank you. God bless you guys. We're talking about one income in a family and how would that help for us to plan for retirement age. Like I said, a couple of days, this retirement issue have taken us over and over again. It's a very broad topic. Come next week, Monday through Thursday, I am going to deal with financial breakthrough. And guess what? I have some solution for those who want to try it out. I will give that solution with places that you can invest. Stock markets that are working out right now with proofs and all that. And what I'm doing for myself and my family. For next week, that's what we want to deal with. I might have a guest speaker who will be teaching us statistics and what to do, strategies to work on our finance. So let's just keep on hitting the financial status that we're going through concerning our retirement, concerning couples, concerning a single mom, concerning a single dad, affecting a student, affecting younger people, lack of planning for the future. It's a breakdown. 911, life-threatening emergency. Stachinello, darling, thank you for joining me all the way from Washington, D.C. I appreciate the go. Thank you. Olukuli, thank you for joining me. God bless you. Obadi, you're welcome in our midst. Thank you, guys. How do we feel for those that are married right now? If you have a stay-home dad or a stay-home mom, either ways, how is that possible to be able to pay all the bills, take care of family, and still have a plan for tomorrow? That's the question. Do we agree that people should have one partner staying home full time? Some people will say they are taking care of the kids. It's cheaper to leave a mom at home while the husband only works because of child care is expensive. I don't know about foreign countries, but in the States here, child care can be really more expensive than those in the third and other countries. But the question is, if I am staying home as a mom, and dad is the only one working, and the income of dad is not sufficient to take care of the whole bills, even when I'm home, is it healthy for a woman who is educated or who has something to offer staying home because she is a single mom and daddy have to work, the children have to be at home, let me say for child care? I want us to think either ways. Everything in life have advantages and disadvantages. Justice, thank you for joining me. Please invite someone else, guys. Share, share, share. Don't just watch, but share and invite someone else. We just want to share our ideas. We want to be able to dialogue together. You don't know who we're going to serve by all these broadcasts. To be at home mom and be comfortable with it. The dad who is working should be making at least 3 times the income of the house. If this guy is making anything less than 3 times the expenses of the house, we need to rethink. We are not talking about temporary issues. We are talking about retirement age. This guy might not be able to save for himself, save for the children, save for the wife by one paycheck. It depends on how fat that paycheck is. So that's what we're saying. Is it healthy for a woman to stay home because she's babysitting children? Maybe 2-3 kids, you don't want to put them in daycare. Your husband is the only one working. Are we thinking smartly? Esther, thank you for joining me. I appreciate it. The question is, we need to balance out. That brings us to the point that I said. How much are we spending in the house? The expect that the children are staying home. The kids are in the house. They are not up to school age yet. And you have to babysit them. I still want us to have a breakdown of all our income and all our expenses. This is the only way to scale through. There's no manipulation and there's no compromise. What we're saying about retirement is sure to come. I keep on stressing on it because I know for sure every one of us individually will must retire. The issue right now for couples who is allowing one to stay at home, we want you to be able to find out how much is our expenses, even as our wife is in the house. Okay, let's say you're making $4,000 in a month. All your expenses is almost $3,000. The kids are still staying at home. You have only $1,000 to invest on in a month. How many of us are surviving with $1,000 to invest on ourselves, our wives, and the kids? It's going to be a lot of challenges. This is where I preach the word, get out of your comfort zone. If the expenses for the kids is taking only $900 every month, I know, I have kids, I've been there, I know what it is. I'm going to give you guys the advantages of taking the kids out and the disadvantages of keeping them in the house. Both ways have advantages and disadvantages. But let's take the advantages first. You know, we always want to talk about the good before we talk about the bad. Okay, you are staying home, saving $900 for your husband because he will pay $900, $300 per child. That's the lowest most people will take. So for 3 kids, it's $900 a month. Okay, mom decides to stay at home to babysit these children. That $900 is saved. But at long run, the issue is, are we able to save money, one guy working for the whole family income and expenses? No, it's not healthy. Do you know why? This guy is going to work 2-3 jobs by himself. At the same time, he will not have the opportunity to spend time with the children. These kids are only spending time with mom in the house. The effect of a hardworking man working 2-3 jobs, coming home, being able to play the role of a dad is really scary and hard to fetch. Some men that work 2-3 jobs, they get home, they are very frustrated. Such pressure on a man can also bring issue between the man and the lady. This man is not able to satisfy the wife. Guess what? When a woman is not satisfied, most of them will be at home babysitting and then sleeping out. We want to balance the issues in marriage financially. We want to put it in a way that it will not weigh anyone down. If you are staying home as a stay-home mom and you're comfortable with that, okay, dad is making some good money paying all the bills. You have missed your intimacy, your closeness with your husband because he put up 2-3 jobs every blessed day to make sure that you stay home with the kids. Now you're feeling left alone. You want him to come and service you at home. He's tired. It's going to affect your relationship. And not only that, that financial burden is going to cut down his lifespan because stress, anyone going through a lot of stress, your lifespan is cutting down. Stress can really bring in a lot of issues health-wise. We want to be able to balance distance. Praise, I appreciate you for joining me. God bless you. Inasmuch as we want the kids to stay home, guess what? Dad is going to miss this kids. Some mothers stay home just to stay home. They don't give their children better life than the ones they will get at there. They just feed them and they stay and watch video, you know, watch movies, sleep and wake up. Most ladies will not have time to educate the children while they are home. And guess what? These kids are missing out from interaction with other children. Yes, sometimes when they go out a lot, they can get sick because of kids, you know, messing up with fluid and all that. Yeah, it's understandable, but it is a way of life. But when you keep a child at home for 2, 3, 4 years, not associating with others, in the name that you are staying home as a home mom, this child, most of them don't get the same level of education with the ones that goes out to mingle with others. Because we all have to learn, even from the age 1 and above, everyone needs to be learning from each other. The problem is, how long will a guy work by himself for 2, 3, 4 years, 5 years to make provision for the family? What if something struck? That's what I tell people. He's making $4,000, $1,000 is not able to give us the savings that we want. If you pay off all the $3,000, you have only $1,000 left in a month, and you don't have discipline to start saving up to $300-$400 out of that money for the future, there is trouble. That's why we're still speaking about retirement and savings, financial breakthrough in relationship or no relationship. Be it a student, be it a single mom, be it a single dad, and couples, it doesn't matter. The main thing is that we have to figure out a way to start saving money. You don't have to be a millionaire to save. Like I always say, you don't have to have so much to save, but all it takes is starting somewhere. The little that you are getting in now, can you start saving a little bit? Do you know the danger of one income in the family? Can you imagine if it's a couple that don't have mutual respect to themselves and they don't have open communication, they don't have honesty and trust, but they've been married for 5, 6, 7 years, pumping children out, husband is the only one working. Wife doesn't know what the husband is doing with income, but she knows that bills are being paid and every other thing she have no clue. Income is not coming to her. She's not making any income herself. She's just sitting down and being fed like they're feeding the kids. What if something happened, that guy dies younger than he's supposed to, which we see every day? Death knocks on the door when you don't expect it. Sickness just crawling into people's life without expectation. Do we think further in future, if stuff like that hits that family, probably the guy doesn't have any savings for the family. He's living his life just like on a daily basis, paycheck to paycheck, and death knock on the door. What will be the fate of these children and this woman in the house? This is where ladies go insane. Most of them will drop their children to the government because they cannot survive it. Some of them will hit depression instantly because of the stress of how do I start. A woman that have been in a marriage for 6, 7, 8 years, have never worked, don't have any income coming in, is a dead woman. I encourage us, that is not healthy. Things don't happen in life. We need to think smartly. We need to think fast, and we need to act now. You might not be able to make the same income with your husband. Can you do a part-time job? Some jobs that you will make will pay you up to $2,000 a month or $1,000 plus a month. Guess what? You can afford to be paying for the babysitter while you have some change left on you. The balance on you can be your savings for life. Since daddy is doing every other thing, guess what? Your husband will reduce the stress on his own side, and both of you will have time to spend with these children. Instead of him staying for 2-3 jobs in a day, 16, 18 hours every blessed day trying to meet up, he can work like 10 hours job. You pick up the 8 hours to cover up. He will have time to spend time with the kids, and you will have time to spend time with the kids. Still, there's income coming in, and we can plan together. These kind of circumstances are the things that push us to be discussing about openness in relationship. Even when you're a single mom, you need to be real to yourself. You need to be open to yourself. What is your plan? What is the layout plan for tomorrow? Muhammad, thank you for joining, Caroline. I appreciate you. God bless you guys so much. Just share and stay tuned. This is not a compromise kind of circumstances. It's not the one we say, healthy relationship or healthy relationship. Yes, you have a choice to make. If it's not healthy, you hit the road. But I'm talking about people's life. I'm talking about retirement. I'm talking about 10, 15 years from now. I'm talking about death knocking on the door right now. And you have two, three children by yourself as a single mom or a single dad. And something happened. Let's say a student, you become disabled. What will happen to these children? Yesterday, we were talking about breaking generational curse. You know, we were talking about all these toxic mother-in-laws coming to destroy family. This is not the issue. The issue we're talking about is you and I. Sometimes we save, and guess what? People live to 95 years these days. A lot of people are living to 100 years these days. And if you don't have a solid background that is laid out financially for those old age, you will suffer a miserable life. You and I need to think fast and act right away. I tell people, from the day I started speaking of retirement, it's not something to procrastinate. This is more like preaching the coming of Jesus Christ, and we think it's not going to happen. It is going to happen for sure. When people say repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand, it is for real. When your door knocks for that debt, your kingdom has come. You have to go and answer that call. You don't have a choice. You know, I used to take it on granted, like, oh, whatever, when is the kingdom coming? But after I lost my child, I knew that that kingdom of God will surely come. You can live without seeing your loved ones. What happens after death? What are we leaving behind for this, our children, our grandchildren? What are we leaving behind for our old age? We pray to live here for a long time. We all pray for long life and prosperity. But prosperity doesn't come just by saying it. It comes with action. And the action starts right now. Living check to check. The way we all live, most of us in the state, most of us back in third world countries, is just like a pattern. Most of us live check by check. Every week or every month or every 2 weeks, we get paid. And when you get the check, the issue is not the check. The issue is how long are you going to live check by check and then match to check. The check comes, you pay it, and you pray the prayer, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. That prayer, that prayer, give us our daily bread. No, this is a generational curse. Daily bread is no longer what we're praying for at this time. If you are still praying, our Father, give us our daily bread, it is a call for emergency. You need to wake up. Daily bread is check to check. You just want to live a basic life. Do you want your children to continue living a basic life? We need to stop the prayer of give us our daily bread. We need wisdom. We need rules and regulations. We need strategies. And we need roadmap. We need landmark. We need plan. Solid plan. We need solidified plan. Set aside on how to break this chain of retiring with broke pocket, retiring with nothing for our children, of retiring, going back to square one, begging food on the street. How can a grown man or a woman decide to stay in the house for 6-7 good years? Even when the children start school, you're still a stay-home mom. You go to school, drop them, you come back. You don't have no income. Not even that. The money your husband is giving you to run the family, you cannot multiply the money. That's what I ask ladies. It's not all about going into clocks for someone. You know, some women and some guys are not called for calling in, clocking in and ask for people. They can think smartly and try something on their own. But if you're that lady listening to me right now, you're very comfortable with your husband doing everything and giving you pocket money, you're sitting at home basically doing nothing, and you're not investing the little change that you have as pocket money into residue, what am I going to do with my pocket money to make extra income, even while you're sitting at home? Something is wrong with you, lady. We have to think and think smart. Machidomele, thank you for joining me there. God bless you. I'm talking about at-home mom, at-home dad. I don't see how ladies can be comfortable for 5, 6, 7, 8 years. Children have started school, and you're still comfortable being a stay-home mom. I am not saying you must work like your husband. Can you do something to help and increase the income of the family so you guys can plan for a better future and a better retirement? Because for sure, retirement is going to come. When it comes, there will be no going back. I've seen some ladies that their husbands are very well to do. They stay home and answer madam. Back home, they have housemates. It's a wake up call. Whoever is listening to me that is answering madam somewhere right now is very good. But guess what? They make money staying at home as stay-home moms more than we that are working. But at the end of the day, they don't have no investment for themselves. Some of them are sitting at home. They can't even say, let me open a boutique or let me open an online business. Do something different from what you've been doing. Don't sit back and just expect the man to be giving you and giving you and giving you. You need to plan for your own retirement. Michael, thank you for joining. God bless you. There's nothing wrong with a stay-home mom doing business from the house. I'm not saying that you don't have enough money. Yeah, you might have enough money, but money is not the issue. The issue is the plan for your retirement. Hear me out. It's not about how much that your husband is giving you every month to make you look good, you know, shop, you know, spend money and all that. The question is, what are you thinking ahead? If something happened to this husband, how can you survive? Some of those ladies don't even have no property for themselves or their children. They don't have no business running. They don't have nothing to show with their money. Some of them will keep the money in account and use it every week and shop and show out. You know, you go to party, you see them, you'll be like, what is going on here? No plan for the future. Any one of us, including me, living right now, hearing my voice since I've started speaking about retirement, and you're not doing nothing about it, something is wrong with us. One income can never be compared to double incomes. There's nothing better than two people working together and making a difference. Nothing better than that. No matter how small it is, but for two people working together, it will always, always make a difference. You know, when single mothers like us complain about income, we want to understand, okay, she's the only one working. But I'm telling you, some couples are living like single parents. Only one income coming in, and it's a struggle. I can tell you, when you have the money stocked up, as long as nothing is adding up to that money, and you keep on withdrawing and paying bills and all that, with that plan, one day you're going to go broke. Okay, let's not even bother about ourselves. Can we worry about our children? Can we worry about our grandkids? How can you live a life without a plan? It's more like waking up in the morning, you don't even know you have to go to work. You're just sleeping in the bed, but you know you're supposed to go to work, but you don't have a plan for that. You just stay in the bed, and you expect manna to fall from heaven. No, you have to plan your day. Those of us that go to work, you have to wake up at 6 o'clock, depending on your work time. You plan your day for the week. How you're going to get up and get there, and the traffic and all that, that's more like retirement. We have to have a plan. I am pleading. If you have a question, post your question. Let's talk. Let's dialogue together. Students, you need to have a plan. Single mother, you have to have a plan. Single father, you have to have a plan. I don't have enough money. You still have to have a plan. There is no excuse. I am telling you guys, this is just like a death sentence. Planning for your retirement is very, very, very important. I have a very good program that I'm going to introduce next week for those who want to try it out. That's what I want to do for me and my kids. We have to plan. There's no two other ways. We have to plan. We have to lay out a solid plan for our future, for old age. We have to plan. How well can I stress this? We have to have something to fall back on. Money is never enough. You can never have enough of money. But when you have investment and plan, a lot of people survive retirement without going back to work at the age of 75. How can we go back to work at the age of 75 when opportunities are all over the place? To be a single individual bringing income in the house is hard. We that are single, I'm telling you, single mothers, I can attest to that. Sometimes you make that money, you see it, but the bills will not let the money even hit your account. Imagine if I have a guy who is paying the mortgage for me. Imagine if I have someone who's paying my car notes. Imagine if I have someone who's at least paying the light bill and water bill and the phone bill. It will reduce that stress. Guess what? That one I'm paying on those can be saved towards retirement. But is that an excuse for me not to think twice? That's not an excuse. Because I could remain single for the rest of my life if I chose to. The main thing is when I become 65, 70 years old and retire, what will I have on the table? Imagine if two couples are together working and they don't have no plan for their future. When they retire, they will suffer. Children of these days, you can't force them to take care of you at your later age. You just have to pray for God's mercy to be upon us that they will remember all that we're going through right now. But the question is, what have you laid down for them? You're expecting them to carry your burdens and take care of you. What have you put aside for these children so that they can live off of it and then stand up on their own? We don't want things to fall apart and center will not be able to hold. We need to think smartly. Single and at-home moms, everyone have to think. If you are staying home, mom, you need to think twice. You know, I tell women or ladies give excuse like, the job I'm doing, I am not making enough, but I cannot leave the job. I begin to imagine. Probably they've not had tough time to really think. You know, sometimes tough time will bring the best out of you. That's what I tell my friends, that through my challenges, the best comes out of me. I stand up stronger when I face a challenge. More like when I get someone talking to me and it's not working out the way I want it to be, or it's not rhyming, I get stronger to let go. Because I hate stress. I would let go and refocus. That's life. Being a single mom, I can attest to you, you get the best out of you. You don't have any man paying your bills. You don't have no brother or no sister doing for you. You don't have no dad, no mom. You're alone with your children. Those stress brings the best out of me. Will I not pay my bills because I am a single mom? That's the question. I have to pick up a second job. It's not that it's very comfortable for me, or I'm loving working two jobs. No, that's not it. It's because I have a mindset of not going on the streets to be sleeping with men just to pay my bills. Because I have a mindset that I want my children to see me being a strong and a good mom who can provide for them. Because I have a mindset that if I work a little bit harder, I can do much better than I'm doing right now. And that's why every day I wake up with a new plan. Okay, what do I do? If you can ask people who knew me, I tell ladies, there's no excuse for you to sit back and wait for manners. Or tell God that give you the daily bread. I don't believe in daily bread. Daily bread cannot be enough for you to save. Quit praying the prayer of daily bread. Let us pray for overflow. Let's pray for multiplication. Let's pray for expansion. Let's pray for favors. Let's begin to pray and put action into our prayers. Daily bread is not a good prayer anymore. Those are in the days of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. These days, our prayer should not be daily bread anymore. Our prayer should be multiplication and overflow, because we can do better. Technology has brought so much opportunities. It is God also who gave people the brain to get all this technology running. In those days, they didn't have phone and computers and all that. Imagine me in Houston, Texas, and globally people are watching me. That is the power of technology in our generation. So daily bread do not work for us anymore. Imagine us if we don't have communication on the social media. How would I pass my information to a brother, a friend, a fan like you? It would be so difficult to do that. But look at us. All of us are seeing each other. You know, you guys can type stuff. I can read it. You can talk. You can see me live. It's happening right now. No longer daily bread. You have to break protocols. You have to get out of your comfort zone. Do you understand? We have to save for the future. We have to plan for the future. This is a serious issue. I used to work as a nurse. I'm telling you, we're in Dallas, Texas. I will do night job. I get off night job. I will still go back to my salon. Because I was doing here before I became a nurse. I did accounting in Nigeria. But when I got here, the money to be paid as an accountant, they are paying you, it's like whatever. Work in Bank of America, you have a bachelor's degree in Nigeria. They will pay you the same thing they're paying high school kids. You have to work 3, 4, 5 years for you to get a little bit of elevation. I didn't have that kind of patience. Even then, I was married. I went to a salon, they did my hair, charged me almost $250. Boy, I got home, I was sleepless that night. I couldn't sleep. I was worried about the damn hair that they charged me $250. I've never done hair before in Nigeria. I called my husband, I said, you know what, I'm going to go do hair, go to hair school. He was just laughing. He's like, oh, you crazy. I said, not crazy. If someone can pay $250 for this thing they did on my hair, I said, no, 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 I better be charging someone that money. He thought it was a joke. The next 2 days, I started looking for hair school. I called up, I went in there, I registered myself. I took the class, and I started doing hair. Before you know it, I opened my own salon. This is real life story in Dallas, Texas. You cannot depend on one thing to survive. Daily breaks do not work anymore. That prayer is a prayer of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. It's not the prayer that we should be praying in our generation right now. We don't have to limit ourselves. Fear should not steal our joy. Amen. Thank you for joining me. God bless you. I started doing hair for real, for real. Before you know it, I opened up a salon. If you ask in Dallas, Texas, one of the first Nigerian salon that was opened in 2004-5 was Jesse's Hair Braiding in Motion. You go online and Google it, it still exists, but I don't do hair anymore. Braids in Motion by Jesse in Dallas, Texas. It was after I opened my salon, my girlfriends that went to the same school to do hair, they started open up a salon. As of 2004, 2003 too, there was no African braiding salon that much in Dallas, but I opened that hair salon. I had 4 or 5 other friends that joined me after. I was still working night job. I had 2 kids. Get up, leave them with the babysitter. I remember a friend of mine that joined me the same way. I won't mention her name now, but if she's watching, she will attest that it's true. We drop our kids as early as 5 o'clock in the morning to go take classes in junior college. When we come back, we'll go to salon and do hair, and we still have to work at night. Can you imagine that? Multitasking just to help and support our marriage. I don't understand how a lady will stay in the house for 7-8 years, don't have nothing doing, but expects husband to save money for retirement. It's hard. If I have known what I know right now, I'm telling you, I would have been retired at the age of 40. No question asked. If I have known exactly what I know right now, I won't be on this social media. I will be traveling all over the world, enjoying my wealth because I saw money. But lack of planning, where is it? Nowhere to be found. Divorce hit, I went back to square one. Because I did not plan. The man did not plan. Things fell apart. Center could not hold. That is what we're singing. It's not a joke. We are saying we need to save. Get your wife to do something on the side. Get your husband who is babysitting. How can a man be babysitting? Because the wife is a nurse or a doctor, then the man stays home. You need to have a little income coming in. And if you can't do that, the income that is coming in is good enough. Well, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Let us plan. Retirement will definitely, definitely come, regardless of how you say it. Aruwes, thank you for joining me. God bless you. We are talking about this retirement like it's a do or die affair. That's how I feel. Honestly, I feel like it's a do or die affair. As a matter of fact, I've decided to call retirement plan 911 an emergency threatening life. I'm not talking about how much you make every month. The issue is how much are you saving and how much investment are you making towards your retirement. It's not about how much you are bringing home. It's how much that is staying and yielding money. Not just sitting the money in the bank. What are we investing so that that money will add up every month, every 2 months? There's something, even if it's a dime on top of that money. That's thinking smart. As you watch me, try your best not to miss the series of next week. Monday through Thursday is going to be a blow on social media. We're going to open up social media to show you exactly what to do, how to do it, to save money, and money will bring money. I must have a life coach that will talk with us. Maybe once or twice next week, but we have to have strategies on how to save money. You stay tuned. Do not step out of your chair. Except if you want to pee, you go and pee and come back. Invite someone else. Let's keep on talking about this. People need to hear it. It's not all about how much we bring. It's how much wisely we're saving. Stay tuned. You all know I love playing music, right? We cannot leave that. So let's take a quick 1 minute break or two. We have to relax our minds, you know. I don't want to hit us, you know, money, financial stability and all that. Let's just chill off a little bit and still continue on the issue of a single income in the family, and then it's affecting our future retirement plans. Awesome, that was a good one. I hope we enjoyed that little music. Let's continue. The effect of a single paycheck coming into the family is not something to write home about. We need to consider these children that we have. Couples, we need to consider our children. What is their fate if we don't plan? We all are making little income, you know. It's not like nobody's making an income. We all are making income, no matter how small. I'm just begging that we should try and apply conscious. Apply wisdom to the little one that we're making. To be honest with you, I can't say it better than I'm saying it right now. I can't even bring it home more than the way I'm doing it right now. It is a wake-up call. 911. You know, when you die 911 here in the state, the whole neighborhood will know that you died 911. Because police, firefighters, EMS, invited or uninvited, they will all bring their vehicles and come on the street. Even if it's a little thing like a little fire in the kitchen, all of them will, department, all of them will show up. That is the call of retirement. If you make enough, it's okay. And it's a good thing. If you are among those that make like 400, 500, 1 million in every year, wonderful, that is good. Can you believe that some people make even more than that? And when they retire, you feel sorry for their life. Why? Because they did not plan very well. Why? Because they didn't think that retirement will hit them. And I ask, how can someone get the age of 40, 45, and you're not scared about your future if you're not planning very well? You're not scared about getting to 50? Then imagine those that are 50 that still don't have nothing saved up. And you're not scared. You hit 55. 60 just around the corner. What will be our fate when we hit the age of 50? What will be our fate is the question. It's very deadly. You know, we need to make sure that those things that are necessary, we have to discuss it. The truth be told, it's very scary when we talk about the truth. But honestly, The truth is very important, and we must discuss this truth. As I preach to you, I'm not just preaching to you. I'm preaching to myself. I pray that God Almighty will help us. We need to think now, and we have to act right now before it's too late. Honestly, if we don't act right now, most of us will be regretting. I'm telling you all the truth. I take example with my mom. When I look at mommy, you know, at this time, when I look at mommy at her age right now, she's 80 years old. I just sit back and say, oh my God, my mom is 80 years already. You know, oh my God. Thank God we had the opportunity to come outside the country, you know, to fight for our future. What if mommy did not train us in school? And I ask myself, what and what did mommy and daddy left behind that can help me and my own children? My mom had 5. Not that much. She didn't live that much. She's still alive. Do you understand? Thank God we are children that are raised and brought up right, that think about our mom and our dads and everything concerning our family. My siblings, all of us are so worried about mommy. Everybody wants her to be okay. Can you reverse that case? If we are children who are minding our business, what would be the fate of mommy if she did not save for her retirement now that she's 80 years? Do you know that that's when she will stay in the village and die in the village? You understand what I mean? She is traveling all over, you know, coming to USA, traveling to London, going to places and all that. Why? Because we are brought up in a way that we have that as a responsibility to take care of our parents and take care of our loved ones. What if we are not raised up that way? Or what if we don't have that mind? She can't force me to take care of her, but I do it as part of my job. What if these generational kids are not willing to do that? After she has been a teacher for all these years and retired, then she would then go to the village to stay forever and ever and die. You see what I'm talking about? That's why we have to think and think fast. That's why we have to think and think fast. May God help us. You guys take a break. I want us to invite more people. As we wait, the Lord will help us. I want to round it up at least for 1 hour. Then we'll take a good break. We'll come back and continue hitting on the issues of one income in the family, okay, as regards to future retirement and plans. It is very important topic. And I promise next week I will try my best to give pure statistics and strategies, ways that we can save and we can put it in practice. I've said the one of $5. Thank God 2 or 3 people have started doing it. And me too, I'm doing $5 for now. You know what I mean? Depending on your income, you don't have to do $1 million. But if you can do $1 million, well, go ahead. I'm doing $5 right now every day, like $150 in a month. And then for the boys, even if it's $50-$60 every month, something has to be given out for our security. And if I can do it for the next 40 years, hey, I will say to hell with poverty. I am going to pay off my house and enjoy myself. That's what I'm saying. Charity begins at home. You guys stay tuned. Yes, 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 yes. All right, my people, I'm back.
And
all right, guys, I'm back. You guys know my enemy. I have to take it. I wish you love. That is Whitney Houston. Awesome. Woo. What a voice. Whitney Houston. What a marvelous strong voice. That's how we do it at Jesse Studio, you know. We don't just talk, we have to relax a little bit and, you know, calm the pressure down, because I know this issue is stressing me, and that is why I am stressing on it. Honestly, it's not funny to be broke. It's not funny to have no plan for the future. Honestly, it's not funny to know that these children will not have any plan laid down for them. It's so unhealthy for us to think about our retirement age with nothing set aside at this time. You that is watching me, be it that you're 18 years old, 20, you know, in your 30s, in your 40s, in your 50s, in your 60s, it don't really matter, 70, 80, name it. The issue is if you don't have a plan, it's very sad. It gives me headache all the time when I think about all that. That at this age, no plan for my children, no plan for myself. What was I thinking about? But you know why I compensate myself? Thank God I have been given the opportunity to realize that. And that's what I want us to see. We have the opportunity to hear someone else sing the music of retirement, sing the music of life saving, sing the music of breaking protocols for our generational security, sing the music of making sure that these children don't go through what we went through. I mean, most of us that are in our 30s and 40s right now, 50s, 60s, we have gone through so much in life already. We don't want our children to follow the same pattern. Those of us that have two parents, one parent is the only one that works. You guys know how hard it is back home. If you're watching me in the third world countries, it's very challenging. Even for couples that are working, my dad was a full-time employee, you know. My mom was a full-time, you know, working. Both of them worked all through their lives. And it wasn't still easy. It was still challenging. Here we are. Can you imagine you keeping your wife at home doing nothing? That's what I tell my brothers, you know, the two brothers that I have, Uchenna and Deze. I love my brothers so much. I can be nosy and, you know, they know that their little sister sometimes can, you know, spell it out without even thinking straight. I just say it before I think. That's what my brothers know me of. I don't hurt my feelings. I always tell them, don't bring a wife who is a layback woman in the house. They might be watching me right now or their wives, you know. The truth be told, if you have a wife who doesn't want to work hard, that's a death sentence. Thank God both of them now are working. Thank you, Jesus. My brother's wife, both of them are working, and I'm very proud of them, whatever they are. Sister-in-laws, you guys keep up the good job. Try to save for your retirement. You know, try to save for these children. Both of you need to think. It is truth. Very hard to chew, but it is the truth. We can't just live the same pattern that our parents have lived. We need to do some changes. We need to take some drastic measures. We have to break protocols. We have to look for insurance. We have to have life insurance. Those things I will mention by next week. We're going to talk about those things. It is real. Things do happen. Young and old will die one day. What do we leave for those who are still alive? Is the question. And if we're alive by the grace of God to the age of 90, 9500, my mom is 80 right now. Praise be to God. Who thought that she would ever live to this age? But look at God doing it. If there's no plan, what is our fate? You have to get out of your comfort zone, people. We have to get out of our comfort zone. We have to do what we have never done before. We have to really get angry when it comes to our future. This is not a joke. This is not an entertainment that, oh, yes, we're talking about boyfriend and girlfriend, husband and wife. Okay, domestic violence, somebody's beating someone. Those things, men will talk and women will talk. These topics are keeping us quiet because we know we're guilty. When it comes to retirement, I know most people have called me privately and they're like, oh, my goodness, Jesse, no, I'm not even thinking about that. It's not all about you having cash in your account now and think you have money. Tomorrow you take $2,000 and splash it. You think you're a big girl or you think you're a big guy. You go to a place, your mates are buying houses. You go and buy the highest house. Oh, I have the cash. Let me just buy this brand new car. No, that's not life. That's not richness. That's proper living above your means. You think you're making it right now? Think about tomorrow when you cannot make that kind of money. What have you laid aside for tomorrow is the question. What have you planned for these children? Should I go to polygamous families? Should I go there? I don't want to go there. Things are messing up. Polygamous families is not only in the third world country. People are having polygamous family here in the States, America. What plan are you having? You have 2-3 children in different places. What is your plan for those children? It's not about getting women pregnant and having kids. The question is, how are you going to take care of these children? What are they going to get from you when you get old? The same thing to women. Things will fall apart. Center cannot hold anymore if we don't have a solid plan. Plan for the future is called for an emergency attention. Retirement is a life-threatening attention. We need to pay attention to our retirement. Some people are retired at the age of 30 because they invested very well. At the age of 30, I'm telling you, some women and men retire. All they do is travel all over the world, have fun, enjoy their money, because they saw money and they invested very wisely. And before you know it, people of 30 years, people of 40 years are retiring right now because of foundation. Foundation. If the foundation is not right, it doesn't matter how much you make. What can the righteous do? If the foundation is wrong, future is messed up. You don't want to be among those that are very rich right now. In come the next 20 years, you're begging on the street. Can you think and think fast? I am stressing on this issue because guess what? Friday is rolling in, tomorrow is Thursday. Friday, you'll be surprised. The broadcast will be more than 1,000 people watching all over global, because that's all about love. I'm all about love, my girlfriend, my husband, everybody's excited. But this one is keeping people quiet because I feel that we are all guilty, rich and poor, middle class and first class and third class people. We are all guilty of this. It's few people that are advancing very well. Don't get me wrong. Come to first world country like United States. There is opportunity for one to make money and work hard, work 2-3 jobs, and you see the dollar coming, you feel excited, you start shooting into people like boom, boom, boom to show up. You have money. Sit back and think. This country is a country that will level you to nobody in a twinkle of an eye. Most people who survive this country and stand out that, yes, they have succeeded, is people who follow the rules and regulations of this country. I said it the last time. America is a country of strategies. If you miss their rules and regulations, the strategies are not there for you. You have missed it all. You see yourself being in this country for 30, 40 years. At the end of the day, you have nothing to show for it. That is how this country is. It's a country that you pay bills every blessed month. Can you imagine that? How can people survive without a plan? In the third world countries, some people will have money. They buy a land and build their own houses. That's their home. That's their house. They'll get a generator and have their own NEPA in their house. You know what I mean? They'll put boreholes. They have their water running. But here in the state, I tell you the truth. I have not seen an African guy or African lady that have a borehole in their own house, that have their own generator in their house full time, 7 days a week. Everybody have to join a company that provide those services. That is how they mapped this country. You must pay those bills every blessed month. You can get any kind of car that you want in the state. But I tell people, why buy a brand new car because your friend bought a brand new car, living above your means? And 2 months contact way, 2 years, the car is supposed to be paid for 5 years. You pay this car up to 4 good years, or 4 years and 9 months. You have only 3 months to pay off this car. You have been paying like 500, 600 every blessed month for 4 years and 9 months. Miss that payment. 2 months to the time to pay off. America will come by and pick up that car. Every dime that you paid in has been wasted. Why are we going to struggle to put our investment in the things that will never yield for us? I was a victim of car recovery. I was a victim as a single mom. I had a brand new car. But just a month for me to pay it off, my business started shaking. I was paying 7 employees as a single mother. The business was going good, but because I didn't have plan, all I was thinking, help this person, do this, do that. I didn't have any solid plan for myself and my future. When the winds of trial came to my business, it swept my feet away. I lost my brand new car that I have paid off almost. I tell people, you tell me, oh, you think it's easy the way you're saying it. I am saying it because I've been there. I'm not just blabbing. I'm not just saying it to entice anyone. I'm saying it because it's real. I lost my solid brand new car just for 1 month left. Even when I pleaded for 2 more days to find a way to pay them, they refused. Before I know it, they auctioned my car. That was how the devil stole away that joy from me. Have I learned my lesson? Big time. I tell myself, I am going to be a wealthy girl. I am destined to be a rich girl. Honestly, I tell it every day. As long as I'm alive, I will never be poor. Why? Because I work very hard. But I'm not going to put my money to someone who will rip it away from me when they have the opportunity. If I have to buy a brand new car right now, I will work for that car and I will pick it cash and carry. That is my goal. I am not going to go through transition of paying somebody every month. And when I have a shaky environment, they will come and grab that away from me. That's what I tell people. Don't look at someone who's driving a brand new car because you don't know what they're doing behind. I am not going to do that anymore. I will wait until I get cash. I will buy the car of my dream. You have to cut your coat according to your size. You have to live below your income. Like I said before, if your income is not quite below, your expenses is not quite below your income, you are in trouble. If you are spending money that is not coming in, every 2 months, every 3 months, you wait for one money to come in, you start living like you got it going on. Something is wrong with you. For you to survive, every income you are making should be 3 times your expenses. That is the first safety. And if you have lost that, you have to sit back and think like me. You don't want to lose your brand new car for you to wake up. You don't want to be kicked out of your house for you to wake up. Whatever it takes, as long as you're not stealing, do something to help yourself. Plan with the little that you have. These things will definitely come. Retirement is just something I can't stop explaining to people. Even my workers, you know, they hear it like song every day. What are you guys planning with your future? What are you planning? What are you planning? I'm singing it to my friends. Anyone that call me, girl, you need to start saving. It's like torture. Ever since I started teaching this class, it's aching me up like crazy. If I have a boyfriend right now, that's my first thing. Baby, what are we going to do to save? If we have to be together, we need to plan. What are we going to do? You don't want to be quiet and get into a relationship that's trouble. Address matters that matters. It's not all about, oh, you're a cheater, oh, you lied to me. Those are not necessary right now. Our future is very delicate. Let us think while the sun shines. I don't think it's a bad idea. Every one of us needs to wake up and shine our eyes. Old age comes with a lot of illnesses, a lot of sicknesses. Most people don't get sick at old age, but I'm telling you, every old age comes with body pain, generalized body pain. It's not a serious matter, but you will have bones that hurt you once in a while. You will not want to wake up very early in the morning like usual. When the weather is changing, it will affect you at old age. Not that it's permanent sickness, but your body will tell you that something is not right the way it used to be. Your vision will change. Your way of eating, your appetite, everything will change. The way you work hard will change. Let us make a solid plan while the sun shines. I hope we all are catching it up. God bless us. I'm about to round up. I've stayed here for 1 hour plus. I need a break because I am reserving my energy for weekend to hit love issues and hit the right place for men and women. So let's just make sure we'll say what is needed. 911, call for wake up. Retirement age must come. Wake up, wake up, wake up. Don't be in slumber. And stop the prayer of our daily bread. Please, if you're praying that prayer, go to your pastor. Let them give you another prayer to pray. Our daily bread is not working for us. God bless you. Hold on and enjoy yourself. You guys stay tuned. We don't drink wine during the week. All right. My lovely fans. The hour has come for me to exit. You know, I work with time. I was given 1 hour today. I did very well. Just 1 hour and 18 minutes. So that's perfect. I'm learning. I'm being disciplined. In my own office, can you guys imagine? It's all good. Everything is rules and regulations. So you guys have a wonderful evening. It's a beautiful Wednesday. I wish us long life. You know, you guys sleep peacefully. Tomorrow, we will talk about this financial issue. We will keep on saying it until the end of tomorrow. Then I will give you guys a treat. You know, you can drink your wine and all that Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Next week, we're going to hit financial breakthrough. And we must break through. There must be testimonies. God bless you all for watching me. I'm not going to exit just like that. I'm going to leave the music to play a little bit. Maybe I'll bring Whitney Houston back on board. As you guys enjoy this music, Jesse, your lovely girl, will be exiting all the way from Houston, Texas. This is your very own Jesse of Sister Sulong Group International. Nigeria. Happy Independent Month to us. The national cake must be shared so that we can have peace of mind. God bless us. I love every one of you for joining me. You guys have a wonderful evening. Okay now. Bye guys. I'm so sorry.